the next and somewhat final piece of the puzzle to convert our dimple.js plot to pure D3 is to actually draw circles on the page. I put a debugger right after all the code we've written so far, and let's check in and see what our page actually looks like. Going back to the browser, we can see the debugger's paused here, and we can see that we have a Y and an X axis. Though they still look pretty crude, they are in the right relative range, going from 0 to what probably looks like 180,000 for attendance. And the years, even though they're very squished and scrunched together, if we actually read them, go from 1932 to 1934 to 1936 and so forth, all the way to 2014 if we look to the far extent of this axis. And now we're so close to having our chart done, and I've happened to save the best for last, the actual circles we want to draw. For the sake of simplicity, I'm only going to recreate the scatter plot. Now that we have a sense of where we are in terms of the axes, let's jump back to Sublime Text and actually create some circles for our data. In Dimple, we simply need to specify that we want to draw some series corresponding to some shapes, in this case, scatter or line. Removing these two lines, and also, since we don't have any Dimple code left, we can simply remove the draw. In D3, there's not an explicit draw function, but rather every SVG gets appended to the page whenever we create it. Remember, in Dimple, since it's much higher level than D3, we simply have to specify what axis this series corresponds to, and it automatically knows the extent, the scale, the axis of that. Now here's another quirk of D3. If you remember from above, when we bound data, we actually appended circles to the page. And now we're selecting the circles already on the page to add an X position, a Y position, a radius, and a fill. Going back to the browser, you'll notice here that there aren't any circles actually drawn, but if we look back at the code from where we started, when we bound our data, we actually appended circles. So what gives? Where are the SVG circles, which are bound to data, which should be on the screen? Answer in the box below where you think the circles are on the screen, or why they're not showing up visually in our chart.